Parameshvarah Guru Sakshat Param Brahma Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. What do we talk about today? Just now, few minutes ago, till 7:56, I was giving a New Year's message to some people in Sydney, one group in Sydney, from 6:30 to 7, 6:55. We'll take that thought itself and meditate on it. Mannatha Shri Jagannatha Madguru Shri Jagadguru Madatma Sarva Bhutatma Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. Whenever we become any person by the grace of God, begins on his inward journey to the self, initially he is groping in the dark. He doesn't know where to go. He doesn't know who God is. He has an idea of God. Call him Ram, Krishna, Jesus, whatever name you give him. But he doesn't know his nature. He has heard that he is Satchidananda Swarup, that this God is Nitya Shuddha Buddha Mukta Swarup, that he is in our heart, he is in the heart of everyone. But he has got no experience about it. So he has no experience how Lord is expressing in everyone, nor does he have the experience of the Lord also. So initially, every student, every person who begins on this internal journey, the spiritual journey, pursuing something more substantial, something more permanent, something not more permanent, something which is continuously permanent. He wants happiness, he wants to get out of this rigmarole of life which is never a straight line, which is always up and down, up and down, up and down. And sometimes he's tired of it. He says, come on man, enough. Is there a way I can live in this tumultuous life without getting disturbed? How do I approach this life? And then somehow he sees here, there, everywhere, people are praying to God. He sees saints and sages who are sitting in peace and quiet. And some, when he thinks about them, God or saints and sages, then some books come to him, and somewhere or people come to him, and suddenly he also becomes devoted to God without knowing what God is. And how do we devote ourselves to God? With devotion, with love, with surrender. He doesn't know what surrender is. He doesn't know what devotion is. So he's told, you know, like you are devoted to your husband, you are devoted to your wife, you are devoted to your children, same way you be devoted to the Lord. Even more than your children and husband and parents, how you are devoted to your body, continuously catering to it, incessantly, without a break, thinking only about the body. This is devotion. where you are thinking about something continuously with love. We think this infatuation for the body, this fixation on the body is love. We think fixation on the relations is love. No. Love is something else. It has to reveal. So, what are we given? We are given a name. Om Shri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram. And who is this Ram? This Ram is Satchidanand Swarup. He is Nitya Shuddha Buddha Mukta Swarup. He is none other than the Paramatma. He is none other than the Narayana, the Ishwar. Wow, he is that. Okay, I'll start taking them. Again, when we start taking the name, it becomes mechanical. So, bhav has to be there, devotion has to be there. And the result of chanting the name of the Lord must be purification of the mind. If mind is not getting purified, then we are going wrong somewhere. Then such a person in the meditation, he gets vision of the Lord also. He gets some siddhis also. Some people get lost in those special beauties which have come to you by the grace of the divine. Because as the mind becomes quieter and quieter and you remain conscious without going to sleep, you remain focused on the mantra Ram, as the cluttering from your mind, that clutter of the world from the mind reduces, automatically the potential of the mind increases. That increase in the potential is the siddhis. But they are also there as a trap. And forget about siddhis. Suppose you got the darshan of the Lord. The Lord appeared in your dream. Lord appeared in your room. It has happened to many people. So, then what do we do? Oh, but he came, he blessed, he went away. I want to see him all the time. Who is this? If Mannatha Shri Jagannatha, if the Lord that I experienced is the Lord of the whole world, then why do I not see the Lord in the whole world? Where am I going wrong in my approach? When this question grabs your imagination, how do I see the Lord in the whole world? I had his darshan in my heart. But how do I see him in the whole world? When this question grabs you from inside, it will make you sleepless. Then the Guru Maharaj will come into your life. Mad Guru Shri Jagat Guru. And what does Guru do? He says, I am not going to say anything because I don't have to say anything. Everything is perfect. No, no, Guru Maharaj, please tell me how the Lord in my, who gave me the vision, how he is the Lord of the whole world. He says, for that shift in vision, for that transformation in your vision, you need to study scriptures. You need to be completely surrendered. So what does the teacher teach? He teaches scriptures. What are scriptures? Scriptures are speech of the Lord. Scriptures are speech of the Lord. Who can explain? Can you read it yourself? Many people make this mistake of studying the scriptures themselves. You are an egoistic fellow. You are attached to your family and relations and possessions. You are attached to your body, you are attached to your past and future, and you want to study scriptures. Who will be the best person to teach the scriptures? Who has realized what the scriptures are saying? And what are the scriptures saying? Tattvamasi, you are that infinite reality. The student, so first he was a devotee. as a devotee he purified himself. Now he is a disciple. Mat Guru Sri Jagat Guru. Comes to the Guru Maharaj comes into his life. Then he becomes attached to the Guru. But the Guru Maharaj will not allow him to get attached. Many people we see, they start keeping the murti, the pictures of their Guru Maharaj. They become person oriented, they become form oriented. But what is the what are the scriptures saying? That you are birthless and deathless. You are supporting all the forms yet without form. So is Guru Maharaj, so is God. You have created that God image out of your own imagination. Man has done that. And that habit, because he practiced it so intensely, taking the name of the Lord, with form or without form, now he transfers all his energy to the Guru Maharaj, so he gets identified with the form. If he started with the form, he identifies with the form. And as he studies the scriptures, many questions come. Yes, he's purified himself through japa or whatever other sadhana. But as a result, many questions are appearing in his mind. And the teacher is answering, taking the support of the scriptures and his own direct experience. And as he's doing that, the student, and he's again and again telling the student, what is he saying? That, hey, the answer is not with me. The answer is in you. Answer is where the question is coming from, there alone the answer is. You are asking me, who am I? You are asking me, who is God? You are asking me, who is Sadguru? All the answers lie within you, from where these questions are appearing. So what is his instruction? Madatma sarva bhutatma. But when you are devoted, such a disciple who is devoted to his Guru Maharaj, he finds the Guru within his heart. What does it mean? It means that he starts discovering that wherever the question is arising in his heart from, there alone the answer is. He stops becoming a chronic questioner who is always seeking an answer from someone, from the Guru Maharaj. Because the Guru Maharaj will give him the treatment after some time, or her. The Guru Maharaj's job is only one, to make the disciple independent. And independence, swatantra, swatantraya, freedom is our nature. This has to be discovered by the student. That is his only purpose, and he'll do whatever is required. Till that student is available, he will instruct. If the student is not available, the teacher, the Guru Maharaj, goes his own way. Then what is the student doing? How does he learn? He learns that every experience that is coming in his life is a teacher. Every blink of an eye is a teacher, every breath is a teacher, every thought is a teacher. So now he is not fixated only with the person. Now he has discovered the Guru principle. Guru principle is, he is, the teacher has become successful in making the student, the disciple, to realize while in relativity, that, because mind is in the relativity. Who wants to realize? The mind wants to realize. The eye wants to realize. Eye is a thought in the mind. If every thought which I interacts with, I know this bottle, I know this book, I know these glasses, I know this laptop. If every interaction of I is able to transport the I to its original I, to its essence, then we have discovered the Guru principle in life. Then Sadguru's grace is upon us. This is at the empiric outside level. And when this happens again and again, everything in our life is reminding us of our nature, true nature, then questioning stops. You start living in present. When you start living in present, there is no onslaught, there is no pressure of past or future, past regrets, future expectations. Not even, am I going to take the next breath? This thought also will not come. You are totally oblivious of the whole thing. You are totally with yourself. And when this Mad Guru Sri Jagat Guru, the whole Jagat is Guru, because every experience that is coming to you is a teacher in life. Who was able to teach you that? One person, one particular person. How did he teach you? Through the scriptures. What were the scriptures? The words of the Lord, the words of the Ishvara. So now your search, your questioning is not to a teacher, but your question, if at all any question arises, you are questioning yourself. And what will that be the what will be that ultimate question? Who am I? That will be the ultimate question. Once you have resolved some all these small things that keep erupting in your mind. And one day, by grace, it dawns. You can get samadhi experience, madatma, I am the atma, there is no doubt about it. And you have studied the scriptures also. And you have purified your mind by devotion to the Lord also. Then somewhere in this deep contemplation, by the grace of the Divine, it will click that I am one without a second. Madatma, Sarvabhutatma, the self, this consciousness that I am, is the same consciousness which is expressing in and through the entire creation. See the beauty. Lord is also called Satchidanand Swarup, Nitya Shuddha Buddha Mukta Swarup. The Guru Maharaj is also called as Satchidanand Swarup, Nitya Shuddha Buddha Mukta Swarup. Atma is also called Satchidanand Swarup, Nitya Shuddha Buddha Mukta Swarup. So where is the difference? There is no difference between these three. This the disciple plus devotee has to realize. When he realizes, he is no longer a devotee, he is no longer a disciple. Because personality is gone, the seeker is gone thereafter. And in this realization, in this disposition, in this poise, the seeker remains. When he closes his eyes, he has no doubt as to his essential nature. When he opens his eyes, he sees the whole world pervaded by the self that he is. In fact, the whole world relative level is just an extension of the self alone. So self is present everywhere. So is the self's location only this body? No. Then where is the location of the self? Madatma sarva bhutatma. The self is all pervasive. The Lord is all pervasive. The Sadguru is all pervasive. When this clicks, you are in there being no better word, you are in deep ecstasy. You are in deep ecstasy. And you cannot but share take one step back. It's not a question of sharing. Anyone who comes in contact with such a person gets affected by the peace, tranquility, ecstasy, simpleness. Shri Jagannathah Madguru Shri Jagadguru Madatma Sarva Bhutatma Tasmai Shri Gurave Namah. When we realize this mantra in this manner, then we have done justice.